Okay, so far so good guys. We have covered almost all the configuration files till now, and only one configuration file is remaining, that is Tslint.json file. So before going to this particular file, let me tell you what Tslint is. So Tslint is basically a code analysis tool used in the software development for checking the TypeScript code quality. So basically this Tslint file checks the TypeScript source code you have written, whether it satisfied all the coding standards and rules that you have defined. Tslint also checks your TypeScript code for readability, maintainability and errors you have done in your source code while writing the code itself. So like, we would be needing some configurations for this particular tool to work, right? So all the configurations for such particular tool is given in tslint.json file, the one I'm showing you here, right? So if you can see this particular file, you can see that there are some rules. These rules actually tells you what all the rules are required, which you need to follow while writing your source code. So like, you know, this particular project we have actually taken from the Angular predefined command, that is ng create and ng new. So this will actually abide all the rules by default. So like, if you run this particular thing on the Tslint, you will find no issues as of now. So but still I'll tell you how to run this particular command. So you don't have to do anything, just go to your terminal, open the new terminal, and there is a command, that is ng lint. This command will actually do the linting thing for you, that is it will actually find all the errors you have done while typing your source code. So if I do ng lint, it will like, it should, in a all better ways, it should say that you don't have any wrong things in your particular project, that is my first project. So let's wait and let's see. So as you can see, it says all files pass the linting thing. So this is like what we were expecting, right? Because this is a complete new project we have taken from the template, that is ng new, and we were expecting this, that there won't be any linting or warnings we will be getting. So now let me tell you how it actually works. So you won't get it until I'll make you understand how it actually works. So let's go to the source code. Here in app.component.ts file, you see that this particular code is perfectly fine. There is no issues. So I'll actually make this code a bit ugly now. This is basically a code which you don't need to understand as of now, because ng on it is a lifecycle method, which I'll explain you in a particular video later on. This is a very initial stage where I cannot make you understand what this particular thing is. I'm just trying to make you understand what linting does for us. So now you can see that while I was writing the code, the linting gives me these issues. Misplaced opening braces. It should be in single quote rather than double quotes. You should not use white spaces or trailing white spaces. So these are linting issues. So now if I save this particular file, I should see that when I run that particular command, I should see some linting issues. So I'll open the terminal again and I'll run this command ng lint for you again, and expecting to have these issues. So it's linting my first project app, and see, there are issues. It says there's a missing white space here. It says misplaced opening bracket. You can see it here. It says it should be in single quote rather than double quote, and it says there should not be any trailing white spaces. So you can actually manually remove this and do what all these particular warnings says, and you can understand and solve these errors. But I'll tell you one interesting thing which is still here in it, that is you can actually remove these errors without doing anything with just one single command. So that's the magic of Angular. Angular actually gives you a command which, with one such command, you can remove all these errors. That is the common errors, not the errors that is complex in nature, but the simple single errors. Even Angular understands it and it can fix for you. So I'll tell you that command. That is ng lint. And your in the terminal you have to write it. You have to write ng lint, your project name, that is my -first -project, and --, fix is an argument this which is required for this comment. So this command will actually remove all the lint issues and it will fix all the lint issues in the project, my first project. So when I enter this thing, I'll see, you just see this particular thing, you will see all these issues getting fixed in a minute. It takes some time. To lint, you can see some changes in the screen. It is actually linting our code. And now you can see that this particular braces are actually here, it is moved to here. All the double quotes are actually changed to single quotes. The trailing spaces are removed. So now all the files are passing the linting. So this is the magic of the lint command, that is minus, with the -, fix argument. So now we will be having the doubt, like, from where can I use this lint software or the tool. So I'll tell you where you can find the lint tool, which I have already installed. So here you can see the extensions tab in Visual Studio Code. Here in the extensions tab, you can just type tslint and click search. So you will be able to see that this is the tool given by tslint. I have actually installed it already. So it's giving me an option to uninstall or disable, but you will get an option here as install. So just install it and then you can restart your Visual Studio Code and all these particular things will start working for you as a tool given which is provided by Visual Studio Code as tslint for you. So that's all about the improving the code quality of your code, and you can, like, this is very useful for you when you continue coding with a very complex projects. So that's it about the configuration files. From the next video and next tutorial, we'll start the actual coding for Angular application.